Good to be here. My first time in Bulgaria also. Hopefully, we will have that. From what I've seen so far, I'm very impressed. My name is Peter Willmot. You can see my poll over there. He's actually one of my students, Willy Dunn. I've been teaching mechanical engineering for the last 30 years. And prior to that, I worked in the engineering industry as an engineering designer. Stefan earlier on talked about black waters in Germany, where universities are located, and perhaps not a lot of people have heard of them. I think we love the university, but there's a small town in central England, as you can see there, approximately 150 kilometres north of London. Now, this is a poster from a project that I did recently, or rather an edited down poster from a project that I did recently called What Motivates Engineering Students? I guess I'm becoming a grumpy old man because I can't help but think a few years ago I started realising that the attendance in my classes, and not only my classes, but college classes, really was getting poorer and poorer. I firmly believe that students are going to have great difficulty in progressing if they don't attend properly. But it is becoming endemic. And lots of students appear to me, and many of my colleagues, not terribly well prepared, both academically for the work, and that heavy workload that we in engineering put on them at university, but also socially, for the different type of, different style of education that they have in university. Now, these were my opinions. And so it made me wonder whether we were correctly designing the course for these students, and indeed, whether this was just a British disease. Now, I was very fortunate at this point to receive a scholarship from the Higher Education Academy in England, which allowed me to travel abroad. And I went to visit 15 different institutions in America, Australia, and Europe. And I didn't enjoy myself, honestly. It was all hard work. But essentially, what I was trying to do was the whole thing came out of a comment that I heard at a conference. Somebody said, and it really stuck with me, you can be the best teacher ever, but if the students aren't listening to you, then frankly, you're wasting your time. And a lot of the stuff that it seemed to me that my colleagues and I were passing over, giving knowledge of, the higher sciences, shall we say, could be potentially quite boring. And I was really quite keen on how we designed our courses, what we could do with our courses to get these students to listen. Because once we got them listening, then we really are halfway there. So very quickly, when I've got very little time around, I already noticed that we're into the poster section, so I can only very much touch on what we saw. But quickly, the project was about what motivates engineering students to study, and to what extent can we improve that by designing courses better. This was done in the universities abroad, where I gave out a survey, same survey for the students, all 30 students that I met with, and then I interviewed each group of students to add qualitative data to what I recorded. And this was followed up last year with my student, Billy, who did a project for me, and did asking the same question, but using a mobile-friendly online survey of our own students at the university. Because what I was finding was, frankly, it isn't a British disease. In all the countries I visited, the same sort of things were coming over and over again, and I really couldn't come up with many major differences, to be honest. It was really a terrible problem. And it's all about carrying the stick, the famous getting the donkey to work situation. And what we're getting, in fact, the previous speaker was telling you, students arrive and they're all commission to try to give us the answers that they think they want us to hear in getting the grades. And no doubt the big thing that we were getting everywhere you went was that the importance of getting marks, the importance of passing in order to make a good career in engineering. But really the area of my interest was more about what would be intrinsic motivators that made them want to go to engineering. Because when I started to be an engineer, 70 years ago, then I did so mainly because I wanted to know how things worked. I was the sort of the sad little boy that would always take the new device pieces as soon as it arrived home and find out what was inside it. So I was driven to be an engineer because of that. And I've seen less and less of this as my high achieving students from school, high achieving in mathematics and physics in particular, at school, with women, but have less and less practical knowledge. And talking to industry, it was very much the practical knowledge that they seemed to value. So here are a few very brief extracts and a few quotations from the research I've gathered to try to summarise the sort of things that we were finding. Now, okay, dismissing this question, please indicate the characteristics of lectures that motivate you to work. Actually, that in itself poses the question. Please indicate the characteristics of lectures. And here we are again, lecturing, information giving to a large audience. There's massive pressure on the institutions to get more and more students on board, to build bigger and bigger lecture theatres, and to do information giving. And just remember my first statement, if the audience isn't listening, it doesn't matter how big the lecture is. And most of our lectures are about 15 minutes long. I'm sure we all know that the dentist might be able to do that. Yet we do it. We're doing it here. We're building, although I should be seeing in 10 minutes. I'll do my best if I do that. I won't guarantee to succeed. But some of the characteristics of the lectures that the students were coming with are highlighted there. Engaging, interesting, real world, challenging. These were all their words. And so they certainly said to us that, that very much lectures can be. But the problem there is most of the staff that we are recruiting in higher education, and this goes for engineering, but for other things as well, are recruited for research ability, their niche knowledge people who are in particular scientific fields. Most of them have got very little education in education or teaching methods. And I feel that's quite sad, actually. And why are we giving lectures? Because they're easy. Essentially, thanks to PowerPoint, it's an easy way of transferring what's in the textbook onto PowerPoint and getting away with it for an hour. And covering a lot of material which we have to do in a relatively short space of time. I feel more motivated to work hard when, which is challenging, I see how it's relevant and important. Something that the students came to me over and over again. They know when the work is just abstract. They know, they can see through it. They really need to know when something's valuable and they can see something's valuable or not. And this is the problem really, because on one hand, you might be valuable to be in the mark, on the other hand, will I be using this in my future career? And they make an assessment of that quite a lot. There's a universal requirement for more hands-on practical work. They mind the practical work, provided it's well set. And they want to work more closely with industry. It's something we're trying to do in Loughborough, actually, working very, very closely with industry. We have two major testing subjects at Loughborough. One is engineering, the very big engineering, and the other one is for science. This is a big expanding work. Then there's the other aspect of understanding what they're doing and getting the appropriate support. And if it's not there, then that destroys all the interest very easily. So what's the least motivating aspects of university students? Write them there at the top on a daily note. All interesting topics. And I like this one, so this is very interesting to me. It's kind of group therapy. The bad vibes pass between each other. What about preparation? I'm going to be maybe a little controversial here for those of you from the secondary education area. These are direct quotes. I really didn't learn a lot at high school, University of Queensland. I feel very badly prepared. I didn't study at all until final exams. RMIT in Australia. I wasn't prepared for anything. I had to start over when I got to here. We learned from each other when we got here. Everyone was only doing the exams. The number of times I've heard that one. Just pass the exams rather than actually learn things for their future career. In countries like Pakistan, this was an overseas student actually in Denmark, studying in Denmark. He said that very little practical work, and he got the same sort of vibes from Egypt. And I've done quite a lot of work in Egypt myself, actually, and found the same thing. So what can we do? We can certainly try to improve our lecture delivery and content. What we're actually finding, and I know I'm guilty of doing it here, but that's mainly, that's partly because of the way that we organise conferences, we organise universities, and we can do it because our financial balance is sufficient. Obviously, if it's financially efficient, but not necessarily efficient from a learning point of view. My marks don't reflect, marks being very important, don't reflect what they think they perceive as their efforts. If they start finding things difficult to understand, they get behind, and then it has a cumulative effect, it gets worse and worse. And some students in Boise State University were in particular, were critical of the move towards electronic media, because it discourages them from those directions, where they are expecting kind of a performance, or hoping for a performance. A motivational staff, I like a lecturer who has discipline. That's good news. They need feedback, and they think that engaging things that are fun. They need things that are fun. I can answer the question. When I'm at university acceptance, that the last question I asked to each group in the focus groups was, do you think that learning should be fun? They all said yes. Actually, I put the same sort of thing to a staff meeting of senior professors within my department a few years ago, and I got some very derogatory comments on that. They're not here to have fun. That's good. Okay, so what did I see? There are a few photographs, and what can we do perhaps? Well, we can change things. We can change how we're going to, how we do things. Very, very difficult with large groups, and it needs a lot of thinking about, a lot more than setting PowerPoint slides like this. But in the University of Queensland, I was really keen to engineering learning centre that was put together. It's a first year centre dedicated to first year engineering students alone. And they have peer mentors walking around helping them throughout their time when they're not in lectures. They can always go there and find help. Lots of practical stuff you can see. In Purdue University in the States, we were finding that they run projects with community service. Very, very positive stuff. We indeed. At Loughborough, these are some pictures from Loughborough, run projects annually as part of the curriculum within the school, bringing industry into the curriculum. And we've reorganised at least one of our study rooms to be a more attractive area to encourage students to feel part of the department and go and work on their own in their projects. slide shows what we've done with our first year students. Alongside traditional scientific lectures, our first year mechanical engineers are formed in two competitions, different durations in the first year. And these are pictures from the first competition. This is a catapult. Design and build competition. These are a competition design and build to in teams, sort of teamwork, and to build a machine device. And one of the really good things in the separate survey from this, we were getting, I asked the question, did you enjoy this course for it? 90% said yes. Now, I'm a guy who used to set laboratories, used to set essays in subjects and I can't think of any one of those where I would have got a response like that. 90% saying yes, you can do it. But of course, the temptation for the new staff is, alongside their lectures, to set essays, reports. There are other ways of doing it. You have to be more innovative. So, towards the future, picking out three points. And finally, some students appear to arrive with misconceptions about it all about marks and also unhelpful values. We need to do what we can to address this, to welcome them, to provide a correct transition to university style. Students need to be creative. They want to be pushed outside their comfort zone, but not too far. That's the trick. To add creativity into the curriculum by using more creative methods. And they need to be given a sense of belonging both within the school and within the profession, because they often